Right, we're moving on to our final two here, and we're moving above the line. So far we've all been down here. Down to begin with, on this quadrant, talking about lots and lots of distillery character, and then moving across into this with the second pair, which we're looking at, or the next three rather, sorry, where we're talking about more wood influence coming through. American oak to begin with the Macallan, and then the ex-sherry cask, which is moving us further towards this end point here, the bridge. Now we're going to move over here, and we're moving up to Talisker 10 years old. So immediately you get smokiness, big hit of smoke. Smoke is coming from the fact that the malting process has taken place. You've played a confidence trick on that barley. It started to grow. It thinks it's springtime. It's ready to put out roots, ready to put out shoots. You've got to rest that growth. You rest that growth by drying the barley to keep those starches locked in there, because you need those starches to make sugar, blah, 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 blah. On the islands in Scotland, there is no coal. There's precious few trees as well, if it's fairly windy. We haven't found oil off the coast of Scotland either yet, but certainly not off the west coast of Scotland. So the only fuel that the islanders had to heat their homes, far less dry their barley, was this stuff called peat. The peat is semi-carbonised vegetation, it's like baby coal, 10,000 years old, compressed vegetation. You dry the peat out, you light the peat, and the peat gives off this really fragrant smoke. Fragrant smoke is full of kind of oily compounds called phenols. And these phenols adhere to the outside, to the skin of the barley itself. So that even though you're taking that barley and then you're grinding it up and you're mashing it and you're fermenting it and you're distilling it twice and you're aging it, in this case, for 10 years' time, that smokiness from right at the very, very start of that process is still there. Talisker for me is always a mix of kind of the sea and the land. It smells like being down by the seaside. You know, people say salty. You can't really smell saltiness, but you can smell the effect of salt standing there. If you ever sail into Talisker, this is kind of the smell. It's seaweedy. It's on that borderline between the land and the sea.